Briefly, your journey.
Well, it's very exciting that I'm back home. Thanks be to the Almighty Allah and to the doctors who have done their best to ensure that at least I regain my health and also that I become stronger again. I have done enough investigations, the thorough and comprehensive tests have been conducted, and they really established the cause of the trouble. I mean, the diagnosis they have carried out has been quite comprehensive, and I'm positively responding to the medication given to me. I feel strong, I feel stable, I feel energetic right now. I'm glad that this investigation was wide enough, was comprehensive enough, and went to the root of the problem after carrying out that thorough diagnosis and eventually giving me the appropriate medication. They were not comfortable with the decision I took earlier on because I visited Nairobi Hospital late last year. I was given treatment, but it wasn't completed because I was rushing back to Kampala to continue with the campaigns because it was election period. And immediately I returned to Nairobi. They raised this issue. They said, please, we advised you not to rush back to Kampala, but you didn't take our advice seriously. So they were a little uncomfortable with the decision I had earlier on taken. But that notwithstanding, they proceeded with the diagnosis, with the investigations, and eventually came up with the proper medication that I've been treated to.
That day you collapsed?
It wasn't collapsing as such. I was attending Mass, a requiem Mass for the late Archbishop. May his soul rest in it. Actually, before I went to the cathedral, I had been on treatment. I was on drip. But because I felt I had an obligation to be part of the processes, be part of the whole program leading to the burial of the late Archbishop. And given the fact that that was a short Mass, it was not going to last for long. I couldn't go to Namugongo, I could not go to all those crowded places. I thought I would attend that short function and then retire home and rest. Unfortunately, midway the program, I became dizzy, I could not continue holding up myself. I felt very, very uncomfortable and unstable, and I had to excuse myself. And indeed, I ended up going to Bagos Hospital where I was given first aid, and thereafter I had to proceed to Nairobi, and the rest is history. Yeah, I assure you, right now I feel energetic, I feel very strong, I feel stable, and I'm set to resume my duties as the Lord Mayor of Kampala to address the issues affecting the people of Kampala. There are a wide range of issues, market issues, those wrangles there about leadership, the leadership of matatu operators, issues to do with implementation of a number of programs within our budget, and also the national agenda of fighting for restoration of rule of law and constitutionalism in this country. We have to continue with this. So I feel stable and strong enough to continue with the struggle and also to continue with the delivery of services to the people of Kampala.